Hey, so tonight I'm going to make some cottage pie. It takes a while to make, and I'm also going to be making mashed potatoes as well. So I'm probably going to end up eating it tomorrow night, but I hope you guys like this, and if you do, you try it out as well.
So these are some of the ingredients for my cottage pie. I've got beef, of course, which is what makes it a cottage pie. If it was lamb, it would be shepherd's pie. So I've got like a kilogram of this. It's oyster blade steak, and it was on special at Woolworths, so it's pretty good. I've got some carrots here. I might use about 5 of them. I've got flour to thicken, some tomato paste, and some onions. I'll probably use maybe 5 of those as well. And I do have like a couple of other ingredients which are gonna be later on, or either I can't remember them, so stay tuned. Okay, so with my steak, I'm going to be cutting it fairly fine because that way it will cook faster. I'm gonna cut it quite small, as you can see. Okay, so now that I've chopped up all my meat, I'm going to coat it in flour. This is gonna help it have some nice color and also thicken the sauce later. So I've just got a measuring cup, not because I'm gonna measure anything, but because it's easier to pull things into without it getting everywhere. So I'm just gonna put some plain flour in. I'm gonna put in some salt, some pepper, and this is just some Italian herbs mix that I just put a little bit in. Okay, so I've got my meat in. So now my meat is nice and coated and it looks really, really strange in a bag. I'm going to heat up my pot with some butter and some olive oil. So just putting some olive oil in. And I'll start heating it up on high heat. And I'm just putting some butter in. Okay, so it looks like it's time to put in my beef. You could do this in batches, but I'm just gonna do it all at once. So I'm just gonna let that get nice and golden brown. I normally top and tail them, cut them in half, and then that way it's easy to get the skins off. And then from there, I just chopped up 3 cloves of garlic and just pop that in there as well. And it's had the cover on for maybe 5 minutes. Okay, and now I'm just gonna clean up and then I'll be back. Okay, so my next 2 ingredients definitely aren't necessary if you don't like them. I've got Worcestershire sauce and I've got anchovies. So anchovies. And yeah, you definitely can't tell that it's even there. A couple of splashes of Worcestershire sauce. Just mix that up. You do want the anchovies to practically break down, so you can't tell that it's even there. And I'm also gonna add some red wine. This is the red wine that I'm using. It's just, I think, like a $5 one from, it's either Woolies or Coles, I don't know. I'm just gonna add a little bit so I can deglaze the pan. I'm gonna add some tomato paste. And then I'm gonna put in 2 bay leaves. Okay, so I've just gotten my kettle boiled and I'm just gonna pour some hot water in to make it more of a stew. I'm just gonna let this stew away for God knows how long, maybe 3 hours or something, stirring occasionally. Hey, so it's the next day. I've just come home from work and I'm gonna make my mashed potatoes. I still have my stew on the stove. So last night I let it cool down, popped it in the fridge overnight, and then when I came back from work, I popped it back on the stove so it has time to cook a little bit more. But these are the potatoes that I have in my fridge. I'm just gonna cook all of them. I don't know how many are in here. 8 potatoes. So I'm just gonna peel them and then cut them into chunks and then put them in a pot with some salted water. Okay, so that's my first potato peeled. I'll just show you how. That's a really long potato. So strange. Okay, so I don't know. The smaller you cut your potatoes, the faster that they're going to cook. But you don't want to cut them too fine because then they'll get waterlogged. They'll like absorb too much water. So yeah, that's probably the size of my potatoes, and then I'll just give them a rinse and then pop them in my salted water. So I cut up all my potatoes, it's in some cold salted water. I'm just gonna put it on the stove to boil until the potatoes are soft. It'll probably be maybe 20 or 30 minutes. So my potatoes have been boiling for I don't know how long, and when I into them, they're pretty soft and the fork goes right through. So I'm gonna bring these now and then start mashing them. So these are my drained potatoes. I'm gonna put the heat on low so a lot of the water evaporates. And I really should get a potato masher because I'm just going to use my fork. What I really want to get is one of those potato ricer things. Those look really cool. Okay, so I've mashed my potatoes a bit and now I'm going to put in some butter. If you have milk, I would warm it up a little bit and then put that in too. But I don't have any milk.
so I'm just gonna do without. So I'm just gonna put a couple of chunks of butter in because it's yummy. And just stir that through. Okay, so I've worked through most of my butter and I'm just gonna put some salt and pepper in to taste, and then your mashed potatoes are done. So I've just got my stew bubbling away, getting thicker, and I'm gonna add some cheese in. Might add some more. So I'm gonna set my oven to 200 on convection. So I filled up my dish, and now I'm gonna put the potato on top. If your meat mixture has cooled, and then the potato won't like sink into it, I guess. But I'm kind of impatient and I really want to eat dinner, so we're not going to wait for that. And with the rest of it that I've made, I'm probably going to freeze it so I can have some more later on. And like, I'll probably make more mashed potato to go along with it when I end up wanting to eat it. And what I'm doing at the moment is just kind of roughing the top so there's more surface area for the potato to go kind of crispy in the oven. And then I'm just gonna sprinkle over a little bit of cheese, and I hope it ends up being yummy. And now I'm gonna put it in the oven. So this is my should make.